My formal training includes probably a year and a half over the course of my whole life, if you put them all together. Engineering is important to me because, first of all, it goes a lot faster when I cut my vocals, when I produce my vocals, and then it cuts down the communication time between the, you know, the producer and the engineer. Also, when I started this, I had an apartment studio, but I couldn't afford to get an engineer for stuff, so I had to learn everything from cutting to mixing, all that stuff. Well, there's a stage of the game when you have to use what you have, but it's always preferable to have the right tool for the right job. I mean, I call it school supplies. It can sound like a band if you want it to, because I can actually play the instruments. And of course, I know cats that can really play a lot of different things too, so a lot of times I'll include my friends. But yeah, I think I do have a sound. I think I have a sound, but it's a very versatile sound because I can do all kinds of music. So that's another reason they call me, because if they want a pop song, then I can make it sound like pop. If they want a jazz song, I can make it sound like jazz. I mean, I just went to Berlin to work with a guy named Till Bronner. He's an amazing trumpet player out there. And I wrote a song for him. I did lyric and melody for that and helped with the arrangement, and they produced it after I came back. It's a song called If I Saw You Tomorrow. It's number 10 on his new CD. And all the way from that to, you know, Jordan Sparks or, you know, some other pop song like that. So I like to move around and do different stuff. I think my overall goal to do with my music is to be one of the cats that help bring music back to music, you know, to real musicianship. You know, everything is sounding very digital right now, and the digital sound brought a lot of cool things to music, but it's been able to drown out a lot of the real musical sound of things that Motown had, you know, stuff in that era. And I want to help bring that back and fuse it with what's going on today, because it's not complete trash. It's just, I think we need a little bit more musicianship, so things can't be so easily copied, you know, so people have more to listen to and be fascinated by. I was able to be a part of the song No Air, principal writer on that song. That was a fairly big song. I got a Grammy nomination for that and a BMI Song of the Year award for that one. I was also on the Dreamgirls soundtrack very heavily. It was a very big movie, and it sold over 2 million copies. The soundtrack itself actually did. So that was really cool. I believe it won an Oscar as well. Yeah, well, when it comes to microphones, the thing for me is I don't want the mic to give me a sound. I want it to represent the sound that is already given the mic. So the great thing about the Lewitt mics is that they give me an unaltered sound. It's just like what I give the mic, that's what I get, the way I want to hear it. So it's great.